Thanks for having me. Go to yeah. Andrew.
Thank you. No. Idiot.
everybody here. Margaret is
a baby.
A baby. A baby. And here comes the bride. Look at that darling bride. Come on, let me see a smiling face, bride.
Yeah, don't tell this to anyone.
Please. Oh, baby, your baby just picked you up. And here's a bruiser. Let me get a good shot of this face. Look at the black eye on that guy and the red bloody nose, and he's fallen down. Oh, what a rough game he hit. Ah, what's that one? Ah! Oh, that's Mom.
Ah.
Ah.
Put your makeup on me. All right, let go. Here, go put this. Oh, God, one of these things.
My dear, he's taking me the whole Halloween.
The whole Halloween, huh?
See you, girls. Girls, get out in the middle here. I want to see what everybody's dressed up as.
No, everybody in there is dressed up as a baby.
Are you sure your mom?
Are they all babies?
Hi.
I see all you baby girls.
Hi.
Baby girls.
We look better an hour ago.
Baby bumblebee?
Yes.
You look better an hour ago.
My girls were
bumblebee. My mommy needs a brownie.
Very nice, ladies. Very nice.
I'm gonna sing you.
We have the chugging bottles on. Make sure they're not drinking anything.
I like soda.
Soda. It could be vodka.
It's scotch. Well, report card with?
Yes, a B plus in math.
And all the
an
rest?
An A plus in English and science, spelling, and an A in everything else.
Very good. Okay, where's Maggie? Nice outfit with my favorite sweatshirt on. And what did you get? Good report cards. Almost all A pluses and one A and one B plus, right?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. And there's Andy. He got a good report card too.
I got A's, B's, and one C plus A.
Because he's just now into big grades where he's got to learn to remember to study for tests. And he forgot a couple times last time, but he's not going to forget this time, right?
Yeah.
Okay, let me see him again. Good girls and boys.
And they already got green grass.
They already got green. They just waiting just from before we came over. He's always picking soccer.
Watch them all looking at their shoes.
Oh, you're just about the same height.
This is the only clue, sir. It says claw.
It said at the beginning.
Oh, take the little baggage to the orphanage, son. That's the proper place for foundlings. Get the man out of here.
Everybody, tell me who you are.
Jason.
Andy. Susan. Steve.
Maggie.
Who's this? Susan.
Christy.
Katie. And there's Katie. Katie. And there's Kyle. Okay, everybody. Give me a wave and happy Thanksgiving again. See you next year.
No, you don't got no money.
Dude,
we got.
It's like Ken Barr stays home and plays.
And reads all the answers
yeah, really,
to the questions.
God, he said it. Boy, he is smart.
We'll take a deep breath.
Bankrupt.
700.
Bankrupt.
Oh,
I
okay.
Caught it, barely.
Hey, give us our free spin back.
Oh, yeah, we want a free spin. Wait
oh,
a minute.
Oh, they get a free spin. Hey. You want to use it now?
Yes,
we do.
All right.
Move it, curves.
Now we want a D. We want a D, girls, don't we?
Or an H.
A D.
Okay,
there is a D. See?
Finally.
Kyle's like, see? For $300.
Okay. Two dads.
Okay, now we want
one of these.
H. Can I get another try?
300. An H.
Okay, there is an H.
A rudge.
Really? All of
them. Well, I want to.
No, you don't.
Happy D,
happy 300, please.
Thanks.
We got our money. We got our money.
Yeah, we're trying.
A
500 a P.
Yeah, pickle. Lots of peas.
Oh, yeah. Jeez, people.
500. 10. 20.
150.
$1,000 and $1,500.
See, now you can buy a ball, Maggie.
I think we can afford
it.
It must be a little bit of a ball.
An N. Wait, you gotta spin.
I
400.
400.
An N.
An N.
Mm-hmm.
As in nasty.
Right.
Yeah, Mom.
I'm sorry.
We want to solve it. Andy
you
wants to solve
not.
It.
You not.
Andy's going to solve
first.
It.
Spin first.
Spin first. Yeah, let's get some money.
This is our money. Don't take it back.
$200.
Yeah.
Okay. Who broke the crayon?
An M.
An M? That's what we said.
We said an M.
No, you didn't.
No, you didn't.
Two M's.
Okay, that's 400.
Yes,
no, you didn't. I gave you all the letters you sent. What do you think I ever said?
100.
For 100? What do you want?
They're all vols.
Oh, then you
left.
Can't do anymore.
Okay.
You're right, there are.
Homemade apple pie.
Right.
That a boy, Andy.
Homemade.
Holy cow.
Homemade apple pie.
Apple.
Sorry. Apple pie. Very good, guys.
I did
a bony little butt on your leg hurts.
I think your uncle helped you a little bit. Andy, I think we recorded
Uncle Hugh's help.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
He's got it on his order.
See me after their Thanksgiving dinner here?
Right.
I think it hurts for their back.
You just have a little time.
Sugar, sugar. There's Captain. He's ready to conk out.
Abby and her friends in bed. Got more hair than you do.
Yeah. Lies more still than I do.
Yeah.
But she never pet me like that.
Well, if you had this much hair, right?
Nice wintry day.
That's right. The only place to be.
We're just 2 days before Christmas. Beautiful out. From inside. Poor dog in his sling. Did she go?
Yeah.
Sure, get out of the way. Sure.
Let that dog up.
She lifted up. I was like,
Sounding
like a
Hugh.
Just from a couple years ago,
obviously. About 4 more inches. There's Katie at the window. It's turned into another very wintry scene here. Not sure how much this you can see, but it is very pretty. Very quiet. Is that usually where you are, Dan? Right? Because he gets very upset when he loses. And Sean and Dan.
Here, Sean, come here.
Go.
be all in.
Sean, come here. Go down here, Sean. I'll get you down. Come here, Sean. Sean,
I can get down myself.
Yeah.
He said he couldn't get down first. Got it?
It's a birthday girl.
Well, we got married at the ceremony.
Sean, I'll tickle wet.
No, it's a compact
VHS. That's how makes you feel real good.
You can use their wedding.
I'm tickle wet.
She's got a regular VCR tape. No, it's got a small tape.
Go, Dougie! 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 Go,
Back up, Kevin. Back up, Kevin. Over here, by me.
famous race car makers, Eddie Roth and Hugh Wiegert. Let me hold up your cars. Let me see your old car. Eddie has
eight advancers.
Sports car.
Gentlemen, seven of these eight will go to district.
Excellent,
Ed.
Excellent.
Number two,
Morgan
Walker.
Number 13,
you're
holding Snickers.
Thank you. Let's hear it.
You're holding it upside down.
Number 19, George Bell.
The Snickers is upside down.
Number 28, Kevin Childress. Number 50, Joel O'Brien.
Nice.
And number 55, Brian Kennedy. I'll give him for a good job.
Are you ready?
Noah's Wife, a humorous monologue by Mildred Wade. The good Lord knows that I am not a complaining woman. But I think I've put up with enough now to complain a little. I can't say that I find fault with Noah. He's been a good husband. A good man. He walked with God and God found him righteous. The people even called him blameless. He's done his part in helping me raise our three sons too. And thanks to Noah being such a good man in the eyes of the Lord, we were spared from the flood. I guess the flood is what I want to complain about. Won't do any harm to complain out loud because the Lord knows my thoughts anyway. Sure, it was Noah who built the ark, but that was no big deal. God told him how. The hard work, all the hard work was mine. What a job it was, packing enough food for all the family and all the creatures without one single piece of plastic wrap. I knew skins and burlap wouldn't keep the mice and silverfish out, but it was all I had. I don't see why they had to come on the ark anyway. I did have sense enough to have the boys not store the food on the lower deck, where moisture would seep into the bags. Cooking for the family hasn't been so bad, but feeding all those animals has been a full-time job. Some want their food dry, others with gravy. The large animals are forever trampling all over the dishes of the smaller ones. Keeping us all in clean clothes sure has been a chore. Oh, we haven't wanted for water, but I sure do miss those large rocks down in the river to scrub the clothes on. And I guess it wouldn't do to mention anyone's name, but one of my sons makes the air just plain unbearable if he doesn't put on clean socks every day. Speaking of smells, sometimes I have to stick my nose up to the cracks in the walls of the ark to smell fresh air. Animals and their unsanitary living conditions belong in the great outdoors. The smell of damp hides and matted fur of the animals crowded together, mixed with the smell of slop for hugs, even permeates to the living quarters. And no one thought to bring even one can of air freshener. Why is it women can't get along when cooped up under one roof? The boys' wives got along well enough when we lived on dry land. It seems here on the ark, there's jealousy and bickering all day long. They complain about which one used the last of the shampoo and deodorant, as if deodorant or a lack of it would matter much here. One complains that her husband got a smaller portion of stew than the other. The other one conscious with how flat the feathers seem to be in her husband's mattress. The other one bemoans that someone hid the flea powder and her husband was suffering. Yeah, fleas came on the ark too. The arguing went on and on and on. I have to step in and settle the complaints and disputes just to keep peace on board. What peace there is with animals squawking and squeaking and cracking and braying all day. There's little peace at night with the owls hooting and the wolves and coyotes howling. Yes, I have many complaints. I've been on this ark for over 40 days and 40 nights. Of course, God has said he would send a wind to dry up all the waters, but that could take a long time, and I'm not getting any younger. Noah's 600. And he's not getting any younger either. I guess when this is all over, and we're back living on dry land, someone will write about the flood and how we lived through it. Noah will get all the credit because he built the ark. They won't praise me for all I did. I won't get any thanks. They'll say, "Into the ark walked Noah, and his sons, and his sons' wives, and two of every creature. And oh yeah, what's her name?